Turnaround jumper up and good. So it's now 5-4. They get a jump shot. Here comes Alma in the lane. 3-point shot from Miles Kendrick is up and good. So the Airedales go back in front. It is now 7-4, 8-4. So an 8-4 game, the Airedales have their largest lead here tonight. Back-to-back three-point baskets have been made. It's always a good sign when you get the three-point shots to drop early, especially in the state tournament. Whitehall, jump shot's on the way. It's in and out, no good. The rebound, Dizzy. That's his first one tonight. Jelani Smith, the rebounder, gets it across midcourt. Here come the Airedales. Easton Box had a big game, 16 points at Mountain Home on Friday night. He had some big three-point shots, a big one in overtime to help the Airedales pull away as Alma outscored Mountain Home 12-0 in that overtime period. Speaking of Mountain Home, they played Benton earlier today. And they come out on the short end, 60-38. They played well in the first half. Alma gets it down low to Izzy. Up and in for two more. So the Airedales extend that lead to 10-4. That's 4 points for Towns Robinson. Beautiful pass down low. That's our first foul of the game. It's on Carmani Smith. So Smith picks up his first team foul here in the opening quarter of play. It's a 10-4 game. Airedales have the lead. Here from Searcy High School. This arena opened up in 2023. It's super nice. Here's a drive up, no good. The rebound, Towns Robinson. Hands it off to Carmani Smith across midcourt, and here we go. Baseline three-point shot for Miles Kendrick. He's 2-for-2. We got a timeout. Airedales go up 13-4 with that basket. A three-point shot made by Miles Kendrick. He's got two of those, and the Airedales lead this game 13-4. And the partisan crowd that made their way over from Crawford County, very happy behind that Alma bench. Got a lot of Alma ninth grade kids down there, made the drive over. So the Airedales have the early advantage here in this ball game by a score of 13-4. Alma 3-for-3 for the three-point line. Had some earlier games, Benton girls. We checked that the Benton boys defeated Mountain Home 60-38. That was the first boys game here at the state tournament, and a couple of girls games already in the books. Greenwood took care of Sheridan 85-24. They led it 35-7 after one quarter of play, so that game not really that close. Here's a shot, jump shot up and in. So 2 points for the Bulldogs, who needed that one. They trail it 13-6. They're going to have pressure in the backcourt. Deflected but picked up by Camden Kerr. Outside to Carmani Smith. Here's Kendrick for three more. That team missed that one. The rebound inside and it's tipped away and comes away with Mountain Home. I'm sorry, the rebounded by the Whitehall Bulldogs. Here's a shot in the lane. Up, no good, but a foul. That's going to be on Towns Robinson. So Whitehall, a chance to get within 7 points. That's a second team foul here in the first half for the Airedales. And a couple foul shots. Yeah, the first one's no good. Next free throw's on the way. He missed that one too. And rebounded for the Airedales. That is 6'7". Easton Boggs. Good sharp passing by the Airedales here in the opening quarter of play. Alma up 13-6. Carmani Smith, who had a gigantic three-point shot in that win at Mountain Home last Friday night. Had a big game, had some late free throws. Izzy on the block, puts it up, missed it. Fighting for the rebound, and it's taken away by the Airedales. Camden Kirk gonna shoot for three, missed it. And the rebound is taken down by the Bulldogs. And Searcy down 13, Whitehall down 13-6, they're down 13-8. So the Airedales lead the Bulldogs by 5 points, four in a row for Whitehall, and they get a block shot in the lane, and here come the Bulldogs. Chance to get a little bit closer. Alma jumped out 13-4, but Whitehall has scored the last 4 points. One thing about the state tournament, we saw that with the earlier games watching, that's a basket made, and the Bulldogs down just 3 points, six in a row for Whitehall. If the officials let you play, they really let people bang around in that Benton Mountain home game. We were watching that game. Alma gets a shot there, gets it down low, and Camden Curd missed it. Pretty good shot, just did not drop in. Here come the Bulldogs across midcourt. Here's a jump shot. They pull up, make it. Eight straight for Whitehall. It's a one-point game, 13-12. And the Airedales are turned over. They hang on to it. They get it down low to Izzy. Izzy lays it off the glass and ip it in. Izzy's got six. And a big point, a big bucket for Izzy. And the Airedales go back in front by three. It's 15-12. Almost got some backups ready to check in here. Chris Salazar will check in at the next dead ball. And Eddie Tate and Tyree McGill. Three-point shot outside is no good. The rebound, good block out by Camden Curd. Here come the Airedales on the baseline. Layup up and in. Miles Kendrick's got eight. Alma back in front by seven. 1:30 left here in the first quarter of play. And that's going to be an offense. Oh, they're going to call a block on that. So all three fouls to start this game against the Airedales. It's on Camden Curd. Towns Robinson will check out. Eddie Tate will check in. Curd is out, and Kendrick will check out. Tyree McGill checks in for the first time, and Chris Salazar. Salazar, one of two seniors who get a lot of playing time on this team. So the Bulldogs down 13-4, battled back, got within one. Now they trail it again by 17-12 score. Here's a shot up and in. Johnson on the bucket, 17-14, and almost had a steal at midcourt. Got our first foul called against Whitehall, I believe. It's on Edwards. So the Airedales up 3 points, 17-14, a minute six left here in the first quarter of play. And the inbounds comes all the way out to Cremonti Smith, and here we go. A minute left here in the first quarter. Alma up by three, 17-14. Cremonti in trouble, passes back outside to Tyree McGill. Tyree in the lane, lost the handle of it, picked up by the Bulldogs. Here comes Whitehall. They could tie it or get within one here with a three-point shot, and it's up no good. The long rebound is Cremonti Smith. Gets it out all the way to Easton Box. Pulls up, three-point shot up. Good! Easton Box for three. Bingo! Alma goes back in front by 6 points, 20-14. So pretty lively game here in this first quarter. Kind of hully-gully back and forth we go. A lot of points, 34 points. Got an offensive foul going the other way. Outstanding job by Chris Salazar. That's on Edwards. Second foul on Edwards. He got both their fouls, so he will take a seat on the bench. Almo's going to be backed up. And get it across, trying to get it across midcourt. Salazar's got it. Finally does so against with Cremonti Smith, and he throws it away. A little bit too quick of a pass, too tall for Salazar to get his hands on that one, and Bulldogs get it right back. Van Buren girls opened up the state tournament today. They lost their game to Lake Hamilton. Pretty tight game. Lake Hamilton won that one. Greenwood girls won their game. Here's a shot up and in. Three-point shot is good. And I'm looking at the signs here. Whitehall pulls within three. It's 20-17, and that'll do it at the end of the first quarter of play. So a really tough turnover and a late basket by the Whitehall Bulldogs. Whitehall's got the red jerseys on, the red shorts, and I'm in Searcy where it's red and black, same color, so yeah. Going back to those state tournament games, the Airedales again played state tournament back in 2019. Alma had, the last time they were in the state tournament, C.J. Mann led them in offense with 18 points. Alma took on Little Rock Hall and lost 67-53. In 2018, they played Watson Chapel. That was in Mom-El. And Tanner Shelton had 14 points, and the Airedales came up on the short end 51-48. 2016, they played Hall again, and Nathan Porter had 9 points. Alma lost 61-38. And the last time they won a playoff game, they won. They played two playoff games in Pine Bluff in 2015. The Airedales beat Lake Hamilton. Austin Lee at 22 points and Nathan Porter at 19. Heath Brittle at 10. And the Airedales knocked off the Wolves 74-55. And then next game on March the 10th, 2015, Alma lost to Pine Bluff 75-59. And Austin Lee had 29 points in that game. So Whitehall down three have battled back. We've got a chance to get even closer, perhaps tie the game on this possession to start the second quarter of play. Bulldogs kick it outside, 3-point shots on the way, it's good. So back-to-back threes, and the Bulldogs have tied this game at 20. Lincoln's gonna stay with some of those backups that come in that play a lot of minutes. Tyree McGill stays out there, and Matthew Rogers has checked in for the first time. Easton Boggs still in there. Izzy's back in, and he is in trouble in the lane. Had it blocked out of bounds and saved, but the Airedales get it right back. Tyree McGill gets it to Izzy. Outside it goes to Boggs. Here is Tyree in the lane. Passes off to Izzy. Puts it up. Missed it. Tapped back out. The Airedales again reset it. Easton Boggs, top of the circle for three. It's short. Another rebound for Alma. Rogers puts it in. That's short. And the rebound, finally, we got a foul down low. I believe that's on Whitehall. That's on Xavier Simpson. So the Airedales up early by 9 points. Find themselves in a dogfight, 20-20, early in the second quarter of play. Tyree McGill up and missed it. Rebounded by Towns Robinson. It's going to be an offensive foul, and Izzy over the top, looks like, and that's his second foul. So Izzy will take a seat. Eddie Tate will check in for the Airedales. So I'm in a little bit of a dogfight here in the early going here in this game from Searcy High School, this very nice arena. Whitehall, the Bulldogs, 6 straight points, all in 3-point baskets. Here's the drive up, and they missed it. Rebounded, tipped around. Eddie Tate the rebound. Eddie's been under the weather, but he's hanging in there. Here come the Airedales the other way. Almost out of travel. Here's a baseline shot up, no good. We got an offensive foul called against the Airedales. That's going to be on Matthew Rogers. So a couple team fouls here early in the second quarter. 6:39 left in the first half. And the Airedales hitting those 3-point shots early, a little bit cold, lead the game, or find themselves dead even at 20-20. Shot clock down to 20. Here's a drive up and in. Whitehall takes his first lead tonight, 22-20. Earlier, about 6 minutes and 15 seconds left in the first half. Alma had that earlier possession where they had all those chances. Here's a drive up and in. Tyree McGill's first basket, and we're tied up again, 22-22. Jump shot up and in. So the Bulldogs, who came in 15-15, I wouldn't say a gigantic underdog, but they certainly are the 4 seed, even though that's an unbelievably tough conference they're in. 5A South. Have a 2-point lead. They played pretty well. They're in a bit of a run here. Here's a travel. Nope, a foul before the travel, so that is the second team foul called against the Bulldogs. And the Airedales get some recruits back in the game. Kendrick checks back in, and Hudson Box will check in for the first time. And also in the game is Camden Curd for the Airedales. Alma down by two. Eddie Tate gets the inbounds pass outside to Kermani Smith. Kermani outside to Kendrick. Drives in. Miles missed it. Layup, no good. And the rebound taken away by the Bulldogs. 5:20 left in the first half. The Airedales are down two, 24-20. So it is a 20-9 run. And a block shot and get a jump ball, I think. It's going to be Alma possession. 20-9 run here by Whitehall to go in front by 2 points, 24-22. Pressure in the backcourt. Camden Curry trying to work it across midcourt, does so. Towns Robinson on the bench with those two fouls, six early points, but a couple of fouls. Here's a three-point shot. Bingo! Alma back in front. Camden Curd knocks that one down. The Airedales up 25-24. Here's a wide open three, and it's good. So Whitehall reclaims the lead. So the Bulldogs go back in front. That matches their largest lead, 27-25. Inside to Eddie Tate, turns around, puts it up, and missed it, and tips the rebound to himself. Outside it goes to Curd. Here's a Kendrick for three. It's in and out, and in and out again. Bulldogs have the rebound. Here's a deep three. It's no good. The rebound, the Airedales lost it. Picked up by Whitehall. Here's a shot blocked. Airedales have the rebound. Kermani Smith has got it. Camden Curd works it to the left side, kicks it back outside. Shot clock down to 10. Kermani Smith wheels, puts it up and in. What a move by Kermani Smith, who goes left. And the Airedales have tied the game to 27. Under 3 minutes left here in the first half. We're all knotted up at 27. That's a deflection and a turnover. Here come the Airedales. And they're going to have a layup. Miles Kendrick's going to have 10 points. And Alma goes back in front, 29-27. 2:40 left here in the first half. So back and forth we go. Ball's tipped again, stolen away. Hudson Boggs, a nice play. Camden Curry the other way for the Airedales to Kermani Smith. Baseline three-point shot for Hudson Box. Good! Bingo, bingo, baby! That's a double bingo on that one. Alma goes back on top by 5, 32-27. Hudson's first basket in three games. He certainly got that one at a big time, and the Airedales go in front 32-27. 2 minutes left here in the first half. Here's a drive to the basket. Blocked by Eddie Tate! Bulldogs are going to hang on to it. 23 seconds on the shot clock. Izzy's going to check back in for the Airedales. Not that Whitehall's going to work any clock because they don't. They just grip it and rip it. Very aggressive basketball team. So the Airedales have scored seven straight. Bulldogs have it on the baseline. 2 minutes and 1 second left here in the first half of play from Searcy High School, the first round of the 5A state tournament. Alma's first state tournament since 2019. Here's a baseline rainbow. 2-point baseline shot's good. That's a heck of a shot. 32-29. The Airedales up by 3 points. Alma gets it down low to Izzy. A reach-in foul against Whitehall. That's their third foul. That's on Hayes. Jay Hayes. That's J-A-I. Alma's got it on the baseline with 1:39 left in the first half. Inbounds comes, and Kermani Smith's going to work it to the top of the circle. Going to run the offense. Going to drive inside. Hits it back outside to Boggs. Kermani Smith left baseline. Shot clock at 20, and we got a whistle. And that's going to be team foul number 4 called against Whitehall. Pretty fast first half here from Searcy, Arkansas. It's on Ramos, his first foul, Cameron Ramos. So another 35 seconds on the shot clock resets. The Airedales up 3 points, 1:15 to play in the first half. Kermani drives in, little dipsy doodle, no good. And here come the Bulldogs running out. Well, that's one of those shots. That's kind of like a 50-50 ball. Here's a jumper and no good. It's tipped out by the Airedales. Last touch by Miles Kendrick, and Whitehall's going to keep it with 1:05 to play in the first half. So two team fouls against Alma, 4 against the Bulldogs. They get the inbounds pass. Fresh shot clock, so the shot clock now at 25. Very athletic team. Airedales and Whitehall played some baseball, and they played some football playoff games. First basketball game. Shot is missed, rebounded by Towns Robinson. Here come the Airedales across midcourt. Here's Box for 3. Easton's got another one. Alma goes back in front by 6, 35-29. Well, they have shot the 3 well here in the first half of play. So the Airedales are going to have a lead at halftime. Let's see what it's going to be right now at 6. Bulldogs take a deep 3. It's up. It's no good. The rebound for Monty Smith. He's got as many rebounds, by the way, as Towns Robinson. So the Airedales, the shot clock is off 13 seconds. They're going to play for the last shot here in this first half. They lead it 35-29. Get it down low to Izzy on the block. Izzy at it block, kicks it outside to Kendrick for 3. Missed it. And Izzy at the buzzer, no good, and that'll do it. So we're at halftime. Alma leads Whitehall 35-29 here in the first round of the 5A state tournament from Searcy High School. This is Kevin Taylor in Airwaves Media. We are going to stay with you here for a minute. We'll kind of recap the first half and talk about some of the history with this Alma basketball team. And let's go back. What a start to the 2000s it's been for Alma. The Airedales played their first playoff game in the modern era. Well, it kind of depends on when you want to say modern era. One of the modern eras really would have been about the late 70s. And on this date back in 1979, the Wayne Woods era and Wayne Bush, Harry Woods and Wayne Bush. Alma came up on the short end losing to the Wynn Yellow Jackets, 73-48. That was at the Pine Bluff Convention Center way back in 1979. Alma played a couple of playoff games at the Barton Coliseum back in 1974. Alma took on all-timer, and they won that game 61-60 back on the 28th of February in 74. I was a brisk 12 years old, by the way, 12 and a half. Alma played Magnolia a couple days later, and Magnolia won that game 78-52. But since the 2000s, it's gone really well. Of course, Alma had that state championship run back in 2005 with Jake Folkerts and all those guys, Ryan Evans. And Alma won that game. The championship game that year, beating Mills. Who can ever forget that great layup at the buzzer? 73-72 in overtime, and Alma had to come back to beat Marion in the semifinals, 48-47. And then they won the other two playoff games, 61-52 over Batesville, and they beat North Pulaski 79-69. Then the Airedales had another state tournament run. They won a couple playoff games. After that, they had another state tournament run in 2011. That will be Paragould, Huntsville, and North Pulaski again. And then they took on Sylvan Hills And Isaac McCoy went for 39 points. And the Airedales beat Sylvan Hills down in Hot Springs 80-64. 2012, Alma won a playoff game over Magnolia. Rock Witters and D. Candelaria combined for 46 points. A couple great dudes, by the way. Candelaria, 27. He was smoking hot. He was really hot during that stretch. He had 20 the next game as Alma lost in a double overtime to Beebe, 85-83. And then the Airedales in 2013 got back in the championship game. They beat McClellan, Greene County Tech, and Harrison. That was down in Pine Bluff. But they lost at Barton Coliseum to Jacksonville, 56-53. And, of course, Brock Witters, the great game, 31 points. Brock now the assistant men's coach at UCA. So the Airedales at halftime find themselves up here by 6 points, 35-29. Kind of back and forth in that first half. Alma led by as many as nine, trailed by 2 points on a couple of occasions, but able to hold on to the lead. They rallied back. They were down 27-25 in the first half. A nice little 10-2 run to go back in front in this ballgame. So the Airedales and the Lions at halftime. We're going to take a little timeout. We'll keep it right here with you. So stay tuned. We'll get third quarter action coming up here. Kevin Taylor, and we are back here at Airwaves Media, and Matt Farrell and his trusty gang getting this game up and going for you. This is a commercial-free broadcast, by the way, so we'll be passing on some time. Alma finished 13-1. That's the first time they've ever won 13 games in a conference. They did it a few times. They won 12 a couple times, and they won 11 three times. Had never won more than 12. And the Airedales finished pretty strong after that loss at Van Buren. They won the next three. Greenbrier, Greenwood, and then the last game, they went up in Mountain Home in overtime, rallied late to win that game 65-53. So the Airedales finished one game ahead of Van Buren. They're the two seed. They will play Pine Bluff. That'll be on Thursday. Russellville finished third. Mountain Home finished fourth. So Russellville's got a game coming up. They will take on Lake Hamilton. I'm telling you, the 5A South is really good league. Pine Bluff, defending state champions, finished third. Whitehall comes in 15-15 on the year. They had some common teams. They played Jacksonville, and they played a couple other Sheridan. They had some Sheridans in their same conference. They had some common opponents on that schedule. But it's funny, you look at it a year ago, Alma finishes 4-10, Russellville 7-7, Mountain Home 7-7, and those teams did not make the state tournament. Those three teams are in. Siloam Springs was second, 10-4, they're not in. And Buren was 9-5 in third place, they're finished second place. And Harrison, the defending 5A West champion, they were 10-4 last year, did not even make the state tournament. Greenbrier was fourth. They were 8-6 in conference play last year, and this year finished 4-10. So we're ready to get this thing going with the second half of play, and it's going to be Bulldog basketball, the first possession. Start this second half, Alma with a 6-point advantage. Coach Dominic Lincoln on that bench. Got the veteran Eddie Quarter down there, and Darren Stoller, Blake Branham in his first year. Third quarter is underway. Here we go. Bulldogs have it. Opening possession to start this second half of play. Here's a kick out, 3-point shots on the way. It's no good, and they get the offensive board, lay it back in for two. Not good position for the Airedales, who give up the offensive board and the putback, and the lead down to four, 35-31. Here is Carmody Smith, puts it up, no good. The rebound is taken off the board by the Bulldogs. Here comes Whitehall across midcourt, a chance to get a little bit closer. It's been a game of runs. Here's a shot, no good. The rebound this time, Alma's got the board. That's Camden Curd on the rebound. Alma kicks it outside to Miles Kendrick. Miles had a good first half, 10 points, couple of three-point shots. Three threes for Easton Box. He's got nine. Backdoor cut to Camden Curd, lays it up and in his second basket. He's got four. And the Airedales back in front by six, 37-31. Bulldogs have it down low. They kick it outside. Shot clock is down to 12. They've not waited much on the shot clock this possession they have. They drive it inside, get a shot up, no good. Towns Robinson the rebound. Kermati Smith back to Camden Curd on the baseline, drives in, spins, turns around, hands it off, and we got a travel called against Easton Boggs right in front of the Alma bench, so they get it right back, the Bulldogs do. They trail it by 6 points. ...37-31 ball game, Alma by six. Here's a shot blocked, but a foul. Oh, man. Camden Curd picks up his first foul, and that's the first team foul here. That's a second foul for Curd, by the way. That is the first foul here in this second half on the air. They call it a shooting foul, so two foul shots for the Bulldogs. They're 0 for 2 from the charity stripe, make it 0 for 3. Not a lot of fouls. They state tournaments, they usually let you play. They've got games to be played, and they kind of keep it, they kind of let you go a little bit. One more foul shot is on the way, and it's up, and this one's good. That's Edwards. He's got 7 points, and the Airedales lead this ball game by 5 points, 37-32. Here's Camden Curd. Kicks it outside the box. Wide open for three. Easton missed that one, and the rebound, Whitehall. So the Bulldogs trail it by 5 points, and another foul called against Alma. That's a reach-in foul. That's her second team foul. That's on Boggs. Easton picks up his first foul. Oh, check it. Yep, first team foul. Bulldogs back it out. They get a fresh shot clock. And you kick it down low, up and in, blocked by Izzy. That was Edwards trying to get it up and in, and the Airedales take it away. Here's Kendrick, and lost it, picked up by Curd outside of Kermani Smith. He'll take a three. It's good! Bingo! Kermani! Alma back in front by 8. He'll do that. You got to watch him. He's getting better and better shooting that three-point shot. Nothing but sweet net on that one. 5 minutes left here in the third quarter. The Airedales lead it by 8, 40-32. Pull-up jumper up, no good. The rebound, Alma. Camden Curd's got the board. He's got Izzy if he wants him. Decides to pull it back out. Smart play. Here's Carmody for three again. He missed that one. That time he missed everything. And it's an 8-point game for the Airedales. Bulldogs have it back. And a reach-in foul again on Camden Curd. That is going to, that's on Curd. That's his third foul. So Camden's got 5 points here in this game. And he will take out a seat. Tyree McGill will check in. That's a tough foul. It kind of lets you play a little bit, and then you have that play. So three fouls against the Airedales. None here in the second half against Whitehall. It's always a big stat with this rule change. And the way that's got to be a travel, but nothing. Big stat with that rule change on the foul situation. You get more than five fouls, and we got a three-point shot up and in. So Edwards scores the basket. And it is now a five-point game, 40-35. Izzy's got it down low on the block, puts it up and in. Izzy has got 8. And the Airedales go back in front by 7 points. Good feed down low from Kermani Smith. He'll also add up those dishes. He'll add up. He'll have 6-7 assists every game. He's very good at passing that basketball. Edwards pulls up, little jump shots up. No good. And Towns Robinson's got the rebound, and we got a foul the other way. This one's going to go against, looks like, Hayes. And the Airedales get the first foul. That's the first foul against the Bulldogs here in the second half. And the first team foul. Alma's got it in the backcourt. Towns Robinson, solid night, 8 points. Got 5 rebounds. Armani Smith over the other way to Miles Kendrick. Here's Easton Boggs, turnaround jumper, short, rebounded by Izzy. Back outside to Kermani. He's going to reset the offense. Gets it down low to Boggs. Whitehall brings out the defense now. Here's Kermani in the lane trying to get it down low. It's a kick ball, so it's going to stay with the Airedales. 22 seconds on the shot clock and exactly 3 minutes left to play here in the third quarter. Jordan Raspberry will check in for the Whitehall Bulldogs. Towns Robinson gets it outside. And Easton Box going to let it go again from three, and no good. Another rebound for Izzy. Gets it back inside Izzy, turns around, lays it up and in. He's got 10. Alma leads it by 9. That matches the largest lead in the game. They led it early, 13-4. And a timeout, Whitehall. We'll stay right here with you. 2:39 left here in this third quarter, and the Airedales have the lead in this ballgame, 44-35. Just a great series from number 11, Israel Towns Robinson's. Daddy's here in the stands, and he's got to be fired up watching that. Talk about some more of the playoffs for the Airedales and the great job Stan Flinter did during his 31 years as the coach, and they had some good runs and good teams. They were in that crazy 6A, 7A conference a couple of years, so that was kind of not good. We were having to play bigger schools, and they had some good players with a little bit of a drought, but they still managed to get in there. Made the state tournament at Russellville back in 2016, lost to Little Rock Hall. Beat Lee Hamilton in 2015, lost to Pine Bluff that year in the second round. I'll tell you, a great playoff game you forget about was that game in Alma back in March of 2014. Forest City rallied to beat the Airedales in overtime, 68-65. And the Airedales, Austin Lee had 23 points. Braxton Anderson had a good game for the Airedales. Folkerts had 15 points. Jake Folkerts, the younger brother of Luke. And the Airedales lost that game on that afternoon. That was a day game. 68-65. So the Bulldogs have it after a timeout. Kicking it around. Rosenberry kicks it outside. 3-point shots on the way. It's in and out, no good. The rebound, Airedales. That's Tyree McGill. Tyree kicks it over to Miles Kendrick. Launches the three. Bingo! Alma's biggest lead. It's 12. 47-35. Miles Kendrick's had himself a ball game. He's got 13 points. That's three threes for Miles. And a steal. Tyree McGill. Alma's got numbers. Tyree lost the handle of it. It's going to stay with the Airedales, I believe. So Alma's up 47-35. Dominic Lincoln off that bench. Calling the play. I'll tell you, that was a great scene in the locker room at Mountain Home on Friday night. Just absolutely an unbelievable emotional scene. Here's a layup from Israel Towns Robinson. Izzy's got himself 12 points, and the Airedales go up 14, 49-35. I don't take a lot of great photos. I'm a very, very average photographer. And a block. I believe that was Tyree, a great picture after that game. Here's Easton Box for three, and it's no good. The rebound out of bounds, going to stay with them. A great hustle from Kendrick, but a great photo, a great picture, just a great scene with the coach. Lowered his head a little bit, and all the players were cheering and fired up and happy. It was just a great moment. Inbounds to Tyree. Tyree put it up and in, no good, and the rebound. Bulldogs have it back. They trail it by 14 points. This is the second 5A West game of the day. The Airedales taking on this Whitehall team. Here's a three-point shot that's no good. The rebound, the Bulldogs get it right back. They put it back in for two, right over Eddie Tate, who was checked in, and we got a timeout for the Bulldogs. So we're going to stay right here. 49-37 as the Airedales with a 30-second timeout are going to have it in the backcourt. I would assume they're going to probably have a press going on, but hey, you think about this Alma team. They went 7-21 a year ago. They won some games. They finished strong in conference. They won their last two league games, and that carried over a little bit. So technically, they had a 12-game conference winning streak. That's a school record. 13 conference wins in a year, that's a school record. So they had a lot of good stuff this year, but and really, I was talking to Eddie Quarter a while back, and Eddie's been around the block a few times, and you're like, well, how many more years you got? And he wanted to wait on this ninth grade team, this group that came in with Carson Kerr and Chase Woods and Luke Stocksdale and Rick C. and Poley, and he's waiting on those guys, and he wants to let the ninth grade group that just finished go through. So Eddie may have a few more years. Ball's tipped out of bounds. But he did say, you got to believe the basketball program certainly in really good shape right now. Inbounds comes to Hudson Boggs, who's checked in for the game again. Here's a pass. Matthew Rogers in the game. Rogers throws it away, and here come the Bulldogs on a run out, and they're going to get a layup. Oh, they missed it. Tipped out. There it is. Have the rebound. How do you like that? Hudson Boggs had a big three-point shot in that first half of play. He's in there. 30 seconds left here in this third quarter. Here is Tyree McGill. Pulls up, puts it off the glass. Bingo. He's got two more points. Tyree with 4 points in the game, and the Airedales go back in front by 14, 51-37. Alma led at halftime, 35-29. So a big third quarter for the Airedales, not only on offense, but on defense. And the old adage is true at any sport and any level. Defense wins championships. Here's a drive for the Bulldogs. It's no good. Eddie Tate, another rebound. And the Airedales are going to have it, I think. Yep, I'm going to have it with 0.8 seconds on the clock. So Alma's going to be in good shape heading to the fourth quarter. 51-37 ball game. Inbounds comes, and that'll do it. So the Airedales, that ball was tipped out of bounds off the Airedales. Let's see if the officials are going to talk this over. And I believe it's going to be Whitehall's ball with 0. maybe 5 seconds left. I mean, hardly any time at all. 0.4 on the clock. So this is absolutely crazy catch and shoot. Eddie Tate was down there getting some water. He runs back on the court. Inbounds comes, and that's going to be the end of it. Goes out of bounds off of the Bulldogs. So after three quarters of play, a nice third quarter for the Airedales. They lead this game 51-37. Kevin Taylor and Airways Media. We got the legendary Evan Shipley with us here tonight. Evan's on board with us. So the Airedales up by 14 points. Lewis here with us as well. Got Tall Dog over here getting the filming for the Airedales. Let's go back to the 80s and talk about some state tournaments. Back in 2003, Alma beat Nettleton, Stubblefield Center. That was a tournament hosted by the Airedales. Alma beat Nettleton and then lost to North Pulaski. North Pulaski, I believe those kids eventually went on to become merged with Jackson. I think they went on to they're now Jacksonville. I think that's right. 2002, the Airedales played J.A. Fair. They lost that game by 13 points. The late, great Daniel Houck had 18 points to lead the Airedales that night. And C.J. McCoy at 12 points. 2001, Alma played Monticello in Greenbrier. Dustin Hughes, who's here tonight, his daughter Brielle, a cheerleader. Dustin had 18 points that night. And Daniel Houck had 14. Alma lost to Monticello 68-61. And before 2001, the other playoff state tournaments, they had won in 94 against Ridgecrest. And then another playoff series back in 88. They beat Salem Springs in overtime. And here is Izzy. Lays it up and in. Izzy's got 14. So a lot of history. Alma's playoff scores over the years. Izzy's got 14 points as the Airedales have their largest lead here tonight, 53-37. 7:35 left to play in the game. 3-point shot for the Bulldogs is no good. Towns Robinson's got the rebound. Hudson Boggs stays out there. Matthew Rogers in the game. Easton Boggs in the game. And the ball is tipped out of bounds. Talk to about Eddie Tate. Eddie's been a little bit under the weather. And Eddie is back on the bench. Inbounds is stolen away. Bulldogs going to get a slam dunk. A little baby slam dunk in there. So it's a 53-39 game. The Airedales have a 14-point lead. Here is Matthew Rogers. Kicks it outside. Alma comes back the other way. Here is Hudson Boggs. Lets it go for three. It's no good. And the rebound goes out of bounds back to Whitehall with 6:57 left in the game. It's a big lead for the Airedales, 14 points. But if you've been watching basketball since the 80s, you know since that three-point shot came to be back in 87, it's a different game. Here's another easy basket inside. So four straight for the Bulldogs, who trail it by 12 points. Easton Box for three. It's no good. Izzy the rebound. Izzy back in. No good. And the rebound, the Bulldogs have it. Alma leads it by 12. 6:25 left to play in the game. Baseline jumper's on the way. No good. Another rebound for Towns Robinson. 12-point lead for the Airedales. 6:15 to play in the game. And a reach-in foul called against the Bulldogs. That is against Raspberry, Jordan Raspberry, 6'2" senior guard. Alma's going to have it out of bounds. Alma's led by as many as 16. They trailed briefly. They trailed 24-22, and they trailed 27-25, and that's been it. Kermani Smith across midcourt. Here's a nice strong move inside, and we got a jump ball. It's going to go back to Whitehall. So the Bulldogs have it. 6 minutes and 6 seconds left in the game. They get it across midcourt, and here we go. Good perimeter defense from Alma. Matthew Rogers out there playing a little defense. Easton Boggs in the game. Now this time they get open. Raspberry for three. It's up, no good. They put the put back in, no good. The rebound, 50-50 ball, and Raspberry's got it. He traveled, no call. He absolutely traveled. They're going to try another three. This is Edwards. That's no good. Another rebound for the Bulldogs, who get it up and in. The pull within 10 points. Their fans have gotten into it. Six in a row for Whitehall. See if they count this basket, 53-41, 53-43 with the foul shot coming. So they got a break. They got the 50-50 ball, and then they got away with the travel. And Coach Lincoln talking to one of the officials. So six straight and a foul shot is no good. And the rebound, out of bounds, it's going to be on the ball. 5:23 left to play in the game. Full court pressure for the Bulldogs. Kermani Smith gets the inbounds pass, breaks it across midcourt, and here we go the other way. Only one foul on each team here in this fourth quarter, so nobody in trouble of shooting some free throws. Here's a pass down low to Izzy and a foul. This one's going to be on the Bulldogs. So their second team foul. 14 points for Towns Robinson, 13 for Miles Kendrick. Easton Box has 9. Here's a pass inside to Izzy. Izzy turns, spins, and he is fouled. He'll shoot two. So that's going to be the third foul called against Whitehall. 5:01 left here in this game. Two free throws for Towns Robinson. Had a nice, solid game here tonight. First free throw is good. Next one's on the way. It's up, and that one's in and out, no good. So Alma leads it. Here's a run out, wide open all the way. Roseberry lays it up and in. So they get an easy basket to cut the lead to 54-49. Kermani Smith, the inbounds, gets it across midcourt. 4 minutes and 35 seconds left here in the game. Carmani Smith kicks it outside. Kendrick gets it down low. Carmani has it back. Well, I'll tell you, a lot of contact everywhere out there. Here is Kendrick on the baseline, covered up outside to Izzy. Here's Easton Box for three. It's no good. An air ball and the rebound, Whitehall. They can get within six if they hit a three here. Roseberry for three. It's up. No good. Rebounded by Camden Kerr. Camden to Izzy. Izzy is going to have it blocked out of bounds. That should have been a foul. I don't think they called a foul either. Holy Toledo. But Alma's going to have it on the baseline. No foul. But it is going to be Alma ball out of bounds. Up 9 points. Tyree McGill will check in. Camden Kerr a little bit shaken up. Here's a shot for the Airedales. It's no good. Tyree the rebound. McGill missed it. Rebounded by the Bulldogs. So the Airedales have gone a little bit cold. Just 1 point. They led it 53-37. It's an 8-1 run. Here's a three-point shot. It's no good. The Bulldogs lay it back in. No good. Again, they lay it up and in. So it's a 10-1 run for Whitehall. They trail it by 7 points. And here come the Airedales across midcourt. Tyree McGill gets it. Pulls up, little jump shot up in the lane, no good. And Towns Robinson tracks down the rebound. Alma needs a basket, just something to kind of slow the mo here. 10-1 run for the Bulldogs. 3 minutes and 20 seconds left in the game. Towns Robinson lays it up and missed it. Got the rebound, lays it up and in. Alma back up nine. 56-47, 3 minutes left here in this game. And we got a blocking foul called. Izzy's pretty good about taking charges. That time he gets called for the block. That's his third foul. And that is the second team foul on the Airedales here in this fourth quarter of play. We got a timeout, full timeout for Dominic Lincoln's team. Leads by 9 points, 56-47. We'll stay right here with you. Go back in time to the 80s in those state tournament games, and Alma had Billy McKinney and Craig Henson, Johnny Thompson. He was a great athlete, a really good athlete back in the day. Played J.A. Fair back in 1986, Doug Daniels, big time scorer back in the 80s for the Airedales, brother of the legendary Stacy King from the 1400 hallway. Shout out to the 1400s. But right now, the Airedales with 2 minutes and 59 seconds left here in the game trying to hang on. And they've got a 9-point lead after this full timeout from Coach Dominic Lincoln. Heck of an effort all the way around. Big game for Israel Towns Robinson, 16 points. I've got him with 8 rebounds. Leland Barclay, Democrat Gazette sports writer, is here. So the Bulldogs have it on the baseline. Down by 9 points, the ball is tipped out of bounds. It's going to be on the ball. Smart defensive play. I think Miles Kendrick got his hand on that ball, deflected it. Alma gets it back with 2:57 left in the game. Pressure for the Bulldogs in the backcourt. Carmani Smith's got it. Going to break it across midcourt. Passes outside to Tyree McGill. And errant pass is going to be a layup slam dunk. And Whitehall cuts it down to 7 points. Carmani Smith has got it. 7-point lead for the Airedales. 2:35 left. Kendrick. Outside to Tyree McGill. Three team fouls on Whitehall, so they've got one more foul before the bonus. They get it down to Towns Robinson in the lane, puts it up, missed it, rebounded by Tyree's no good, and well, that was Boggs on the tip. Here comes Whitehall, a chance to get closer. They trail it by 5-7. Here's a shot, no good. And we got an offensive foul going the other way, called against Whitehall. That's her fourth team foul here in this fourth quarter. So Camden Curd shaking up. He's back in the game, by the way. That's good news to see. I was looking down at Patty Webb to see if what was going on, and I couldn't find Camden because he was back in the game. Alma's got it out of bounds. 7-point lead. And almost a foul. It is a foul. That's going to be the fifth foul, and Miles Kendrick will be at the free throw line. A chance to extend this lead. Alma leads it by 7 points with 2 minutes and 4 seconds left here in the game. So Miles Kendrick will shoot two. Nice game for Miles. He's got 13. 17 for Izzy. First one's good. He's got 14 points. That's really the strength of this team. You just never know who to guard because it may be Camden Curd one game. It may be Kermani Smith. And tonight, one of the unsung heroes, Miles Kendrick, two free throws. He's got 15 points, 14 points, and the Airedales 15 points. The Airedales lead this game again by 9 points with 2 minutes left to play, 58-49. Here comes Whitehall. They get a shot. Let's see if they call the offensive foul. Yep, that's on Whitehall. Nobody really said what was going on, but Airedales get the turnover, and with a minute 53 left, they almost got the ball back. Camden Curd gets it across midcourt. Alma's got numbers, 3-on-2. Camden's going to drive to the basket. Wide open layup, up and in. Alma leads it by 11 points, a minute 42 left in the game. Boy, what a heady play for Camden Curd. He's got 7 points, and Alma goes back in front by 11 points. Here's a three-point desperation time for the Bulldogs. No good, a rebound, Izzy, and a foul called against the Bulldogs, and with a minute 25 left to play, you better believe it. How sweet it is, baby. We're going to round two. Alma's going to win this ball game tonight. Airedales have the lead by 11 points. They've got it in the backcourt. Kendrick gets the inbounds pass, gets it over to Camden Curd. To Kermani Smith. A minute 15 left here in the game. Alma by 11. A little dicey there for a minute, but they held on. Kermani Smith breaks free, kicks it outside. Got a minute left to play in the game. Alma fans are up. Gotta love it. And we get a travel on Kermani Smith with a minute left here in this game. Bulldogs have it back. 60-49. Bulldogs, 3-point shots on the way. It's no good. They had some early, but nothing in the second half. And the Airedales get it back. And Alma leads this game by 11 points. Here is Kendrick. Drives around. Alma's going to have a fun trip back to Crawford County, boys. Airedales, 30 seconds left here in this game, kicking it around. So these fans who made the drive over certainly have enjoyed this. 10 seconds on the shot clock. Here's Izzy. Outside it goes. 3-point shot for Boggs. Up. No good. And the rebound in Whitehall. 20 seconds left. Just a matter of the final score. It's a run out. And it's going to be a slam dunk. It's no good. The foul is on Miles Kendrick. 14 seconds, 14.9 seconds left to play in the Airedales. Have this game in the bag. First playoff win for the Airedales since 2015. March 8th, Lake Hamilton, 74-55. The last playoff win for this Alma team. And the first playoff win for Coach Dominic Lincoln. How about that? Lincoln and the Airedales will be 21-9 as they will gas up the bus and head back to Searcy for a 2:30 game on Friday afternoon. Free throws are good, so the Bulldogs trail it by 9 points with 14 seconds left. Camden Curd's got it, and he's going to run the clock out. Whitehall is not going to foul, I don't think. And the Airedales win this ball game tonight. How sweet it is, boys! Airedales get the W. Alma goes on to win it by 9 points, 60-51. 17 points for Israel Towns Robinson, 15 for Miles Kendrick, the Miles Kendrick. And Alma wins its playoff game tonight by 9 points, 60-51. This is Kevin Taylor for Airwaves Media saying so long from Searcy, Arkansas.